The problem of child labor has been a nagging issue among African countries, including Zambia. This is the practice that excludes children from social and many beneficial activities such as school. Although there have been arguments between child labor and child work, these practices are distinguishable, as explained by Zambia's Labor Commissioner, Chanda Kazia.
The other achievement that we want to have is a clear distinction between what may be child labor and what may be child work. Because usually people want to misconstrue child work vis-a-vis child labor. And this has been an ongoing kind of discussion in some sectors. You know, like we always say, child labor, anything that is detrimental to the physical, social, you know, emotional growth of the child, anything that is detrimental is, you know, considered child labor. But anything that enhances social values is child work, because then you're able to teach children some life skills. So that even if you died, you dropped dead, they're able to pick up those skills and survive. So there's a clear distinction about that.
Okay.
And especially for the rural community, we need to do that.
In an attempt to eliminate child labor, the Ministry of Labor, with key stakeholders, convened an African Regional Conference on Child Labor Elimination and Public-Private Partnership at David Livingstone Hotel in Zambia's tourist capital in Southern Province.
Now, this employer is saying, we are also confronted with the safety and health issues. Can you come and provide the guidance? The way I look at the guideline by the task force, I think it is actually stepping on the iron mandate.
And we have to look at it in totality, as what Mr. Jifunda said. That is only one, not only one part. There are two parts of the two conventions and the framework, and then what are the implications of that towards us as member states? Thank you.
A valid reason for pushing forward to go with tobacco production, because we all know that consumption of alcohol has certain impacts on your health. But alcohol is still being sold and produced. So those are some of the things that I think are important in what he was raising. How do we do research in terms of backing what we're trying to propose? I think would be, for me, an important outcome of this meeting. Thank you.
The challenge is quite real. The challenge is enormous. We need time to plan. We need time to think. We need time to visualize 2030, 2063, where are we going to be as Africa?
Wildlife Organization on Tobacco Production. Are they against the tobacco production? Or are they worried about the people that are actually into tobacco production, going into, again, elimination of child labor, and yet they are the ones who are at the center of demanding more labor into tobacco production? What is the concern of
World
Health Organization?
This is in view of the ILO Governance Body meeting in Geneva from 26th October to 9th November this year. One of the agenda items for the governing body is to review the public-private partnerships that are concerned with labor trends and child labor in the tobacco industry. The meeting will also review the nature and scope of the current engagements with tobacco companies. The effect of the review is a possible ILO withdrawal of the public-private partnerships with the tobacco industry, which may have a devastating impact on many African countries where they have proved to be a successful model.
This is just in readiness for the delegation that will be going in Geneva. I think from the 26th to 9th of October, there will be the governing body that will be sitting, and it will be intense and it's representative. And you know that the ILO is only tripartite kind of engagement, where you've got parties who are governments, you've got workers, and employers. So you've got trade unions and you've got federations of employers, and all these voices matter. And if you look at how we clustered and the delegates that have participated in this meeting and this regional meeting have been appreciated from those kind of clusters. And that's what sets a tone in terms of, do we appreciate government's thinking? How is the regional thinking and perspective as well?
It is with this background that the Ministry of Labor recently convened at an African regional conference to come up with a common position on public-private partnerships with tobacco-producing companies. Some of these public-private partnerships include the Elimination of Child Labor in Tobacco Growing Foundation, ECLT, and the JTI public-private partnership through the Achieving Reduction of Child Labor in Support of Education.
For Zambia, the position is very clear, as demonstrated by His Excellency the President of the Republic of Zambia, Mr. Edgar Chagwa Lungu, during the recent United Nations General Assembly, where he provided reassurance in one of the side meetings that public-private partnerships are at the core of Africa's development agenda.
The participating countries included the host Zambia, Malawi, Zimbabwe, Tanzania, Mozambique, Uganda, and Ethiopia.
The PPP has to have a multi-sectoral approach. It is not something that you can say one size fits all. What works in Zambia cannot work in Malawi, but it can be redefined to suit the situation so that it works in Malawi, and then redefined so that it works in Mozambique, redefined it works in Zimbabwe, and same is in Tanzania. But the basic concept can be the same, because we are all trying to address and protect the very people that are our citizens in the different countries. Looking forward to having a strengthened PPP with the different sectors. Here we've come with on the Arise project, which is funded by JTI for the different countries, as well as to come up with a common approach.
The Ministry of Labor is particularly optimistic with the public-private partnership concept in eliminating child labor in the region. This was evident in the keynote by Minister of Labor Joyce Simukoko. The address was delivered by her Permanent Secretary Barnaby Mulenga.
Now, coming to the issue of public-private partnerships, distinguished delegates, ladies and gentlemen, perhaps one of the success stories in the fight against child labor has been the collaboration between the Zambian government and the Arise project. Zambia is one country that has benefited from the public-private partnership in the area of eliminating child labor in the tobacco cultivation through support by the Japanese Tobacco International, JTI, working in collaboration with the International Labor Organization. It is gratifying to note that there are several new projects that have come up, several new public-private partnerships under the ILO. And as was indicated earlier, 93 of new projects have come up compared to when there were just a few in the past.
Since the inception of public-private partnership, there have been success stories where such projects have been implemented. The children have been sensitized and are aware of the effect of child labor on their lives, as explained by 14-year-old Makinishi Mponyela.
Child labor has a lot of effects. One of the effects, it makes us children not concentrate on schoolwork. Let me say, like the activity that were taking place to in our community. Find whereby parents were sending their children to go and offload drugs of groceries that those sellers buy from or sell. The children they had to they will offload there and then brings the money to the parents. Two, parents were giving their children heavy loads, containers. If a child is 11 years, he's been given 20 liters to go and fetch water. Children were also sent to go and collect firewood from a far place. No, child labor is not all about carrying heavy loads. Also distance, it's also child labor.
Other beneficiaries of the public-private partnership and related projects, such as the Arise program, witnesses to how community life is being transformed.
These savings, they are a group of women. We make 20 to 25 women. We form like a small group. If you want, you can name that group. My group is CEJ group, which means working together. What we normally do, we have to save money, the amount of money we can afford. Like we start 5 kwacha to 200 kwacha.
Conference participants are hopeful there will be concrete steps taken to eliminate child labor by participating countries.
I think we need to agree on the concrete steps instead of us gathering in workshops and conferences, instead of us having policies, instead of us having legislations. We should deal with the issues, because you can have a policy, you can have a law, but in practice you find that you have child labor. So what we need to do is go beyond the papers or framework we have agreed as individual countries. What are the concrete steps we need to take to make sure that we give the law the effect? If the law says youngsters are not supposed to be found at the workplaces, what is it that we should do to make sure that that is put into action? So that's what I'm expecting. I'm expecting that countries will share how they have dealt with this issue. As I indicated earlier, it will appear like it's a regional problem.
With such regional conferences, they set platforms to share ideas and best practices that will eventually eliminate child labor through public-private partnerships.